We're back. F me in the three stars and call me Tyrone. Good to see you, Tyrone. Alright, so we're still around in Shinjuku. We're still where that cinema is. Which, as soon as I get far enough away from it, I can show you Godzilla. And around here, it's kind of like you come here at night. This is where the dodgy stuff happens, like all the really dodgy bars. You can just see Godzilla's toes sticking out over there. Yeah, there's a nice little dodgy club right there. But we're not going in. We're not going in. We got other stuff to do. Just see more of him sticking out. Oh, and earlier when you asked there were sex shops about, one of them's just up there. That one that I was remembering earlier. Ah, there we go. So you can see his face sticking out. So we have him there, Godzilla, on top of the cinema. How'd you like that, Tyrone? Okay. So as you can also see, it's getting a lot busier now. There's a lot more people. There's also a lot more people just taking pictures because we are sort of moved more into touristy Shinjuku. Torjuku, maybe so. Yeah, you can see him a lot better now. I think... Can you hear that? If I cut my hand this way... This music! It's Godzilla-esque music. Maybe it's because it's 2 o'clock. It'd be really cool if he did something though. I can hear him growling. Oh, I know some cities. Oh shit! His mouth is flashing and there's smoke coming from there. There's also people on the roof. I didn't know you could get up there. Well, some cities will have clocks that have no... There's more smoke. Clocks that have normal alarms and normal chimes on the hour. Shinjuku has Godzilla going off. I've never seen that before. I didn't know he did that. I guess I've just never been here on the hour. I'm imagining now just turning, facing this way and be like, "Oi, I didn't say you could film me. I don't know why I've got an Australian accent. Fuck off." So, 2 o'clock Godzilla. Wow, man, it's so clean there. I love it. Well, it depends where you look. Certainly, compared to a lot of cities, it's very clean. I wouldn't recommend licking the ground. Oh. All right, so let's head on this way. There's a really cool restaurant. I remember someone asked me last time about robots. There's a restaurant over here somewhere called the Robot Restaurant, and they put on a huge, awesome robotics show. And they have food as well. Now, I've been there once. When I first bought the ticket, I was thinking to myself it was a little bit expensive. But for what they do, like, I don't think they cover their costs. And I know I was actually surprised. Is it left or is it right? I think it's left. Might be over there somewhere. Oh yeah, there it is. so you can just see it on the right. And I'm not gonna linger, because around here is very, well, as one does. So it's just here, it's the robot restaurant. It's awesome. And the robot ticket counter in there. So you can see these guys, like, the staff will actually get in them. And it's full on activated robot action, robot fighting action, and it is really awesome. So you can sort of see, it's 8,000 yen for the show. And like they really cater for everyone, so photography's allowed, it's family friendly, it's a kick-ass show. But like 8,000 yen, at first, you might sort of think to yourself, oh, that's a bit much. But when you, like, go to the show, you really don't think you paid enough. You think to yourself, like, well, this must have cost a lot more than 8,000 yen per person who's attending. Game center. All right, we're gonna go to where you guys wanted us to go. Karaoke. Yeah, we're gonna go to the gay zone, where we're just gonna walk through. We're gonna try and be subtle. Oh, this area, by the way, it's called Kabukicho. A lot of people will want to come here. I always recommend avoiding Kabukicho. Well, at night, anyway. It's just... It's just icky. To word it in a manner a child would understand. It's icky. So as you can see, Shinjuku proper's a lot more busy. Again, we've got to take into account that it is Friday, so a lot of people are at work, because again, it's 2:05. But again, we've got lots of humongously tall buildings, and that's a lot of cloud that's coming in. I hope we're not in for rain, because Vending machine. Yeah, I hope we're not in for rain, because I don't have an umbrella or anything like that. Shidax. Karaoke. I'm not doing karaoke on the stream. I thought I'll get that out now. I enjoy karaoke a lot. And I go somewhat frequently. Right, let's cross this road before we miss the green. Oh shit, that's going to change quickly. Yeah, so I enjoy karaoke a lot, but no, I'm not gonna treat you guys to my awful warbling. I'm not even gonna call it singing. So again, like, bike parking as well, it's quite regulated. So you've gotta, like, if you wanna park here, then you've gotta have a contract set up. So you can sort of see just there. So it's about the bike information. This is area number 16. And I think if you wanna park, you might have to, like, get to City Hall. I know where I parked my bike in Nakano, as long as there's room, you can just pay 100 yen. And that'll do you for the day. So here we have the Isetang Kaikan, big shopping centre, I think. Probably. Never been in there. And we have an awkward moment now where I think this guy's blocking the road for us. Yep. Thank you. Oh, I hate it when people like hold the road open for me. Because it's so awkward. I'm like, oh, just let the cars go. I think I can wait. I can wait. All right, I'm just scrolling back through the comments. I'm actually quite surprised that even though the stream dropped a couple of times, I can see these comments. All right, Smooth Rider, you wanted to see the gay area. We're nearly there. I think. If it's where I think it is. Oh, our money. So yeah, if it's where I think it is, we're almost there. So yeah, get ready. Someone selling flowers. A lot of flowers. I presume they're selling flowers. I don't know what they're doing. I feel bad now. Someone just up ahead with a super dry jacket. And there he goes. It's an interesting fact. That brand, as far as a clothing brand, is illegal in Japan. Despite the fact that they use Japanese text on it and whatever, which, by the way, my Japanese friends find hilarious, because, well, whenever you see bad English on a shirt, this is the equivalent. It's bad Japanese on everything. Do you go there very often? I basically live there. No. So, Starbucks. Now, it's round. I think it's just starting over there. Well, that potential flower seller has music coming off of them. It's quite nice, quite lovely. All right. It smells around here. Again, this is probably something contrasting to the earlier, man, it's so clean comment. Yeah, something around here smells. It's kind of sewagey. It's unpleasant. Yeah, I'll definitely be there 7 days a week. Don't know about you. Well, five of them 7 days a week I'm at work, so that's a definite no. Oh. Alright. I think it's like, I mean, like, here's a police station, or a police box rather. I think it's from the next right. I mean, it's not massively obvious, like, it's not just like a massive sign saying, hey, this is the gay zone, or this is where all the gay bars are. Wait, I have been there. A couple of my mates wanted to go. Yeah, we went for one of my mates' birthdays. That's why I remember this suit shop, I think. Yeah, I completely forgot about that. I think that was when I first got here, like back when I was still living in Hiroshima. Oh. Alright, so that's the first right. No, that's not it. Memories are coming back. Oh, there we go, parking. Back on our early conversation. Gay bars are nice, ever been to one? Yeah, I've just sort of remembered now that I had gone to a bar. I think I actually went to two. I can't remember if it was two or just the one. Around here. We had a great time. Drinks are a little expensive, but in Japan, drinks are expensive when you go to bars. So, because there's a publisher's there. So basically, around here is where you've got all the bars and a soba shop. So, as I said earlier, I'm going to try not to keep anyone's head in the shot at all. It's a nice food place. So we have a shop here that sells piggy banks and shoes and underwear. So there's a couple of bars over there. I think the one that we went to was down a side street. I wouldn't know it though if I saw it, to be honest. Bar over there called Campy Bar. I wonder how campy it is. I guess it's not incredibly campy, otherwise it would be called like Incredibly Campy Bar or something like that. Yeah, just a little campy, bit of campy, and bicycles still. So I mean, like, as far as this area goes, it's a pretty normal area. It just so happens that this is where all those bars are. So I mean, like, we had convenience stores over there, restaurants, everything's still... I mean, there's a barber as well. The net cafe as well, so everything's still same as everywhere else. We have our first rainbow flag. Sorry, the only clue. That and Campy Bar. The only clue is that this area might have any kind of bars or whatever of us for a particular, or catering to a particular clientele. And that's basically it. Because again, like around here, you've got your old regulars, like 7-Eleven, Rainbows! So, let's go down there. We're gonna cross this road. We're gonna go over that way. I think there's a park. And I think I just accidentally pointed at that guy. I did not mean to. So I'm now looking slightly to the left and I'm gesturing over this way now. Try and make it look as if I wasn't just pointing directly at the guy. Oh, the worst part is he's crossing the road too, so we do have to cross paths. Oh, this is a long and awkward green light. We got some good news though. The battery problem that we've had, it is going up. We're at 61%. So this cheap and crappy power charger is doing its job. Oh, so did you want to go to the gay bar? Or did your friends? My friends, like, when I came over, I was literally spending the Christmas period here, and that was my second ever time in Tokyo. So I didn't know anyone except my friends who already lived here, and I didn't know any places or anything like that. So my friends all recommended going out, and en route there, they said, oh, by the way, because one of our other friends who was joining us. Because he's gay, we're all going to go to a gay bar in Shinjuku. And I just said, okay then, let's go. There's a cafe over there called Oops. I don't want to know what they accidentally dropped in their food. Oops. So yeah, my friends wanted to go, but they went anyway, because I've got no problem with going to gay bars. I think I went back in uni, again, a couple of my gay mates wanted to go to gay bars, and they were like, John, come join us. And I'm like, yeah, okay. For me, as long as a bar is good, as long as it's fun, as long as the drinks aren't too overpriced, then yeah, I'm fine with bars. As long as I'm allowed in. And again, I've yet to have the situation of a gay guy in a bar hitting at me. So, or rather, if they were, I didn't know. it's this Largo. It's an outdoors shop. So, it's a really cool looking statue there. So, you got a girlfriend? Or had one since you've been in Japan? Yep, me and my girlfriend have been together for about 2 years, just over 2 years and a bit. What month is it? February. Yeah, 2 years and a couple of months. Yeah, so that answers that. Often in like streams or YouTube videos, I often refer to her as like the missus. That's not literally to say that we're married. It's just a British thing. We just say like, how's the missus? We just mean it as like, how is the significant other who is female? Doesn't it happen oftenly that you're not allowed to a certain bar or a restaurant? To be honest, it's not happened to me. In fact, it's never happened to me. I've never once... Bloody hell! That's windy. That's... Yeah! I don't know if you can see. I'm walking into the wind. Oh, doggy. Oh, sorry about that. It's never happened to me. I've heard anecdotal stories, or anecdotes, I guess an anecdotal story would be. I've heard stories about people being refused. But to be honest, when I've heard those stories, it's always sounded like, well, it seems like you got refused for a pretty good reason. Like there being a bellend or, you know, something like that. Something on towards. Ah. So we're in this little garden now, or rather, we're going to enter. So, please refrain from acts that would cause bother to other people. Stay down, stay down. Yeah, so, most of the time that I've heard of people being refused entry is because they're being loud, awkward, obnoxious outside the bar. In which case, I wouldn't let them in anyway. Like, I think sort of the point is a lot of people will instantly take the hump and be like, ooh, they're not letting me in because I'm a foreigner. No, no. That may happen in a very small number of bars. But most of the time it's because... and again, it's something I mentioned on the last walk we did. It's where people don't like entitled, obnoxious tourists. As long as you go somewhere and you're like, hello, I'd like to come in. or roughly thereabouts. Then you should be fine. Like I said, I've never had an issue with getting into places. I think it's only ever happened once, and that was back in the UK. And again, that's because I was wearing the wrong shoes. And fair enough, places have dress codes. And that's the same as in Japan. So again, like, if you do get refused, go somewhere else. Don't take the hump. Like, take your business, take your money to somewhere that wants it. That's a nice little brook there. As far as restaurants go, I've never not been allowed into a restaurant. Yeah, restaurants are normally pretty good. There's times like where you can't go in because you don't have like a reservation and it's full. And again, that's fair enough. Off on a tangent there. Oh, cool, is she Japanese? Yes, she is. Don't get blown away. I'm trying not to. So maybe even if it does rain, it's a good thing that I don't have an umbrella, because it'd definitely get broken. You guys got a storm coming in a bit. Yeah, with that wind and that cloud, I think you might be on something. Oh, what's this? Parking. I'll bet that's paid parking though. Yeah, there's... You'll very rarely find free parking in Japan. Well, in Tokyo anyway. A lot of times there'll be a case of, like, if you're using the store, you're using the facility, it's free. You might have to show, like, a receipt or something after. Ah. It's a nice stream that doesn't look like it has any flow. Oh, wait. It has a circular flow, so nothing seems to be going anywhere. I'm no riverologist, a flowologist, so I have no idea what that means. Have you ever been stopped by the police? Yeah. basically, if, well, the police have the power to stop anyone and ask for ID. I think the law is they're allowed to stop non-Japanese and ask for ID. But there's sort of a grey area there. Because, like, you can't tell from looking at someone who is Japanese. Like, if, say, you were born here, raised here, you have a Japanese passport, but it just so happens that your parents were born, like, in America and they're white, you'll be white, but you're basically Japanese. So if the police were to stop you then, I wouldn't know what would happen, because situations never happened to me. But again, similar thing, as long as you know the law, and as long as, like... Oh, I want to see if this car parking's free. It probably isn't. Oh, I don't want to go down there. Looks like you've got to pay to go in there. And I'm cheap, as you all know from my YouTube channel. So yeah, police do have the power to stop you and just sort of ask for your ID, what you're doing, and so on. And again, as long as you're not a massive bellend about it, you'll be on your way in like a few minutes. And again, I've heard lots of stories about people being all like uppity and smarmy and sarcastic and basically trying to be a jackass. And quite rightly, they've taken a long time. So basically, if you're in Japan and you're on holiday, you have to have your passport. You've got to keep your passport on you at all times. If you live in Japan, you've got to have ID. Like, I've got my driving license and I've got my proof of residence card, which everyone who lives in Japan who is a foreign national will have this card. They used to have a different card, but it was changed, and it's basically a card that you have. So as long as you've got one of like that, and a policeman stops you and asks like to see it, just show it. And then like if the policeman asks you something like, so what are you doing around here, you're like, well, I'm just out for a walk, thought I'd stream it to Twitch and see if other people like it. Then again, like they'll check your document, it's fine. They'll radio through it and check, it's fine. And then they'll hand it back to you. They might like ask other stuff, and then you'll be on your way. I don't think I've ever been stopped twice in the same area. So when I first moved to Tokyo, within the first week, I was stopped and like asked to show my residence card, which I did. Showed. 5 minutes later, I was off. And I've never been stopped after that. And again, it's not like it's something that happens. Oh, this. All right, hang on. I'm gonna have to concentrate here. This is. All right. Cross that road, because that's about to change. Yeah, so I've not been stopped that many times. And, like, anytime you do get stopped, don't be a dick, and you'll be fine. Okay, I can't cross any of these roads. I'm right in the middle. I've heard police like to stop foreigners for no reason, just to check on their documents. To be fair, a lot of police, like I actually asked one police guy who was off duty because I was drinking in a bar with him. I asked him about it because we were both drunk and we didn't really care what we were talking about. And he said that he doesn't like it.